हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान एंड आई वेलकम यू विद वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर स्टूडेंट. इट इज़ चैप्टर 13, व्हाई डू वी फॉल इल. सो इट इज़ द लेसन दैट इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू अवर लाइफ और अवर इम्पोर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द लाइफ दैट इज अवर हेल्थ. देर इज वन कोटेशन स्टूडेंट दैट वॉज रिटन बाई महात्मा गांधी. इट इज़ ओनली हेल्थ दैट इज रियल वेल्थ and not the pieces of gold or silver. Yes, student, health is wealth. And we realize it when we lose it. So what should we do? We should have the preventive measurements from which we don't lose this important gift of the gold, student. What is health? Health means the physical, mental and social well-being of an individual. And the physical, mental and social well-being of an individual is known as individual health. And physical, mental and social well-being of the society is known as community health or the social health. One individual can maintain its health with the help of personal hygiene by taking the care of the personal parts or by taking the bath. One can take care of his or her health with this, by taking the balanced diet. As you know that the food contains the different nutrients, and if we take all those nutrients in the balanced amount, then we can't have the deficiency diseases. With this, regular exercise means when we do the regular exercise at that time, there is a proper circulation takes place in our body, and with the help of that, we can also maintain our health. With this, student, health awareness. Yes, this chapter is related to health awareness. If one individual is aware about the health, then he or she can easily take care of his or her health. So, with the help of these things, one individual can take care of its health. Now we come on the community health. That how can we take care of the community health? Like by having the neat and clean environment, especially green and clean environment, we can have the good community health, student. With this, adequate nutrients food means if the food is available all the people in the society, then the whole society can have the good community health. And with this, social equality means if in the society there is no tension and there is communal peace and harmony, then one individual or that particular community can have the good health, student. With this, social awareness is also one important aspect from which we can have the good social health in our society. And immunization is also the important aspect to maintain the community health, student. Like in your childhood, you have the different vaccine, like the vaccine of polio, hepatitis and cholera and the typhoid. So all these vaccination to improve your immunization system, student. So with the help of the immunization, we can also have the good community health. Now, student, there is one question is in starting. Why do we fall ill? What are the reason of illness, or what are the reason of the disease? That we will discuss now. There are the different reason, student. Like main reason is infectious reason and non-infectious reason. Like the infectious reason, student, in nowadays there is one most horrible disease is spreading in our country, and it is COVID-19. So this disease is caused due to the infection, means it is communicable disease, and it spread person to person with the help of different environmental factors. If we have this disease, then this disease is known as infectious disease, student. So infections or the pathogens are the main cause of the infectious disease, and due to the pathogens we have the different diseases like AIDS, flu, typhoid, common cold, cholera, malaria, and this disease that is spreading in nowadays, from which we are facing the problems, and I am teaching you virtually, not really. So it is COVID-19, and COVID-19 is also one infectious disease, and it is caused by one virus, and that virus is known as COVID-19 virus. And this disease was started in December 19 from Wuhan. That's why it is known as COVID-19 disease, student. Now we come on the non-infectious causes of the disease or illness. First cause is physical cause, student. Many times suddenly the accident takes place, and due to that accidents we lose the particular organs or we fracture the bones, and that particular disease or that illness is known as physical illness, and it is also the cause of one disease. Next is deficiency disease, student. If we don't take the nutrients in a balanced amount, then we have the malnutrition disease, student. That's why we should take all the nutrients in a balanced amount. For this, there are the different deficiency diseases the persons have, like the due to deficiency of vitamin A, one person may have the particular disease that is known as night blindness. Like this, due to vitamin B, one person may have beriberi. Due to the deficiency of vitamin D, one person may have the rickets. So these are the deficiency diseases, student. Inherited disease, student. There are some diseases like anemia, hemophilia. These diseases are passed generation after generation with the help of the parents, and those diseases are known as inherited disease. So inherited cause is also the cause of disease, student. Next is degenerative. Due to the degeneration of the different organs, we have the different diseases like goiter and the loss of the sight, student. We have hypermetropia and the myopia. Drug addiction is also the one important cause of the disease, student, or the illness. Drug addiction, like the addiction of alcohol or addiction of nicotine or addiction of some medicine, narcotic medicines, is the one cause of the illness, student. So these are the causes from which one person fall sick or fall ill, student. Now in the next segment we will discuss the types of disease. We will discuss, today we discuss the causes of the disease, and in the next segment we will discuss about the types of disease, student. So thank you very much, and have a healthy day.